I was asking myself, said, where has God gone to? You know, in those years, people were being changed and transformed. Today, people are not changing. He is the same God, because the Bible says he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. God hasn't changed. What has changed is just our approach. It's just the way we are doing things. Now, we are bringing God back in our lives. We are bringing God back in our church, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are bringing God in our nations, in our cities. We are bringing God back in our homes, in our families, in our marriages. We need God everywhere we are. We need God in our offices. We need to see people repenting. We want Azazatiah. Listen to me. We want, you know, when people, you know, encounter us, they have to encounter God, not encountering Felix. They have to encounter the Lord. They have to encounter the power of God. When someone is demon possessed and have an encounter with me, that devil should be uncomfortable, because has come in the presence of the Almighty. I am the carrier of the presence of God. I am the carrier of the power of God. Therefore, when I come in a place, I have to intimidate all the devils in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Why? Because I am of God. I am born of God. I am born of the incorruptible seed, and I am a carrier of the presence of God. Amen. So we have to get to a place where we embrace the supernatural God in order to experience the supernatural power. Oh, we refuse to be void of his power. We need the power of God back in the church. We need to see people, Christians, who are excited about Jesus. People who are celebrating Jesus, not just celebrating testimonies. People were celebrating, you know, God's heart, not celebrating his hand. People were celebrating that the Lord is God. Oh, the Lord has done this in my life, has saved my soul. Not celebrating that the Lord has given me a car. We need a generation that will be able to celebrate the goodness of God. People who will be able to say, the Lord God loves me, and the Lord has saved me, the Lord has delivered me. Oh yes, I was once a bad person, but now I am a good person. I used to be a wicked man, but look at me, the Lord has made me righteous. Oh, we need such a generation in our time. Praise be to God. Amen. We need such a generation that shall be able to celebrate the Lord because he loves us. People will be able to celebrate the Lord's heart, not his hand. People will be able to celebrate God Almighty, that the Lord has saved me, not because the Lord has given me a dress, not because the Lord has given me a jacket. Hey, those are secondary things. Come on, church. We need a supernatural God in our lives. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. 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 You know, someone said that the church has become like, you know, this drive-in places where you drive-through, where you just say, I need chicken, I need rice, I need this and that, and then you drive through and you go home. We have turned the church into that. You know, just give me what I want and I will see you the next time when I want it. Oh, we need people who shall be planted. We need people that shall come, that I am here not for a miracle. I am here for God of miracles. I am here to seek God of miracles, not to seek miracles. Are we together? I am here because I need God in my life, not because I have a need, not because I am higher. Oh, where is that generation? A generation that, you know, shall open its heart, that I need this God in my heart. I need this God in my heart. Not a generation that shall only open its hands and say, Lord, give me, Lord, give me, Lord, give me, Lord, give me, Lord, give me. No! We need a generation that shall be able to say, God, I need you in my soul. I need you in my heart. Lord Jesus, I need you. I am nothing without you, Lord. We need such a generation. We need such a people. A people that shall bow their knees before God. A generation that shall call upon the name of the Lord, knowing that we can do nothing without him. Oh yes, we need to get back to the Lord. We need to get back to Jesus. We need to get back to Jesus, where we shall cry out to him and say, God, I need you. Lord, if you are not involved in my life, Lord, I will be dead. I can never survive without you, oh God. People that shall be hopeless without God. We don't want people who are independent. We need people who are dependent on God. We need such a generation, such a people. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh yes. Oh yes. That's why we are here tonight. Is to seek God. Is to get to know God. Not to know about God. To know God. To know God. That's why I'm here to invite you. You're not a place of expectation. To have such an expectation. I refuse my expectation to be cut off. I want my expectations to be met. I need God in my life. I have such an intense anticipation to see God in my life. Like, God, I want to see you. God, I need to see you. Listen to me. If we need to see Namibia change, we need a people that have that intense anticipation for God Almighty. That divine God, that supernatural God in their lives, those people who shall be so open to him, saying, God, I need you, oh God. I expect you, Lord, to do something in my life first and foremost before you get it to do to them. Lord, I need you, oh God, Lord Jehovah, to change my life, oh God. Before you get to change my neighborhood, oh God, Jehovah, start with me. Lord, before you get to change Namibia, oh Jehovah, change me. Oh Lord Almighty, I am here, my God. Lord is standing before you. Lord, use me. Lord Jehovah, use me as a vessel, as a conduit. We need such a people in our time. We need such a people that shall come before God and say, God Almighty, Lord, oh God, I make myself available. Use me, oh God. If you do not use me, Namibia shall perish. Oh God, use me, Lord. If you don't use me, Lord, Vindoka shall perish. Lord, you have to use me, my God, for me to see this nation transformed. My God, you have transformed my life. Lord, I want to see revival on my clock. I want to see revival, Almighty God, in my time. I want to see revival today. Jehovah, let that revival start with me, oh God. Where is such a people? Where is such a people? Where is such a people? Them that shall cry before God, Lord, I need you. I need you. Expectation determines receptivity. We need people that are so expectant that God wants to use me. God wants to use me. God wants to use me. A people that shall see themselves as conduits. People that shall see themselves, you know, that, you know, God, if you do not use me, my family is going to perish. That, God, if you do not use me, my God, my nation will perish. God, there is no other option. I lay my life before you. God, use me. I lay aside everything. I lay aside every weight, oh God. Father, Lord, I want to see you, Lord. For the sake of this nation, my God, I lay aside everything. I lay aside, Lord, my desires. I lay aside, oh God, every longing of my heart. God, all I want to see is to see you working through my life, touching the generation, touching my city, touching my nation. We need such a generation. We need such a people. A people that shall be able to call upon the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, hallelujah. Now listen to me. What you do not expect, you can never, never recognize. You know, the expectation is very low in the body of Christ. We need that expectation in order to recognize. God can be moving, but because of no expectation, it can be moving and touching my neighbor. Wow, is myself, I can't even understand what is going on because I'm not expecting him. If you are not expecting anything. You are expecting nothing at all. Nothing at all. Then you are going to experience nothing at all. So there should be some expectation. So tonight, expect God moving in your life. Expect God not only visiting. God does not visit. God is here with us. He has come to live with us. Expect him right now to begin to do the work that he has said he will do. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. Amen. Now, there are two instances, and I will end with this in the Bible. You know, when Jesus visited his hometown, people there rejected him. You know, they didn't say, oh, we don't want you. No, they simply despised him. They naturalized him because they knew Jesus. They grew up with him. So they said, who is this one? Where did he get all this? Oh, yeah. So they rejected the supernatural. Now, Jesus, being God, he was 100% man and 100% God, but yet he could not do anything in that place because people did not receive him, did not recognize him. They only remember that dirty boy that used to play around. They said, who is this one? Where has he gotten all this? Oh, you know, they naturalized Jesus. But now today, we are going to receive Jesus as the supernatural master, the supernatural God, the risen savior. We know better that Jesus is well able. He has all the power to set us free. Praise be to God. And there is another incident. A woman who had, you know, an issue of blood. The Bible says she said in her heart. She said in her heart. That was, you know, that was to me. She recognized Jesus as the supernatural God. That if I only go and touch the hem of his garment, I shall be healed. And what did she do? She pushed herself through the crowd and she touched Jesus, and immediately she was healed. Are you one of those tonight who will push himself or herself through the crowd and touch Jesus Christ, knowing that he is the supernatural Jesus, the one who is able to save my soul, the one who is able to change my circumstances, the one who is able to change my heart, the one who is able to deliver me? He is the only one that can do it. Tonight, I am calling you to have such an expectation to say, Jesus, Lord, I open my heart, Lord. I am not seeing man there. I am seeing you because you have sent that man. You have sent that woman. Jesus, you are speaking to me. That word is coming from your mouth to my heart to change me, Lord. I receive that word because your word is incorruptible. And that word, oh God, is bringing life into my life. Oh, praise be to God. Tonight, have that high expectation and our lives shall never be the same again. Praise be to God. Do we have that high expectation tonight? Yes. Are we expecting the power of God to be made manifest? Yes. Can we rise to our feet tonight in the mighty name of Jesus?